Hello, I'm Ken Colt, and I'm glad you made it to another episode of Frostpunk. And last episode, we started to expand our housing area because we already made contact with new survivors, which also already are back in action, or better, back in town. And yeah, finally, or I hope finally, we are more or less set up to be self-sufficient and don't have to worry too much anymore. And the next few things we have to enact a bit is to increase our food production. And then I guess we are fine to go further in the story. And let's fire up our generator a bit and see how this goes. Yeah. So, for this episode, as I mentioned already, we try to keep going and start to fulfill our search for another settlement. We started some episodes before. And also go through our technology level. So right now, we want to improve our scouts to be a bit faster. And yeah, what do we want to do afterwards? I guess we could... Well, we have to take a look at the food, of course, as I said. So I guess the best thing we will do is to research the flying hunters, which are really, really awesome compared to the normal hunters that we have here. So let's see how this is going. Speed up a bit. Oh, I can speed up a bit. Last days, last episodes, no time went by. I have the feeling, but right now I can even speed up things. So yeah, let's see how the people are working. Or do they work? I hope they work. What do we have here? Yeah, our research is finished. Great. So now our scouts are faster. And let us go straight to the flying hunters, which is really, really nice. The flying hunt build allows us to build hunter's hangar. And it's technically the same. So they also work at night and come back in the morning, but around double the food capacity. Now that I think about it, I don't know if the hunter's gear works for both. It only says hunter's hut, so I guess this research doesn't improve the doesn't improve much of the hunter's hangar. But yeah, we also have a technology down there which is improving the output, and we have also a nice technology here, a hunting techniques, which will reduce the amount of workers we need per hunter. Which then, again, let me show, should work for both. Hunter's Hut, it states Hunter's Hut. I think it's also working for the Flying Hunter, we'll see. So again, give us a bit speed, and let's see how the people are building. So, also, when taking a look, oh, I didn't research it. Talking about researching and now do it. Great. Guess free time for the people. Well, from time to time they have to take a break, maybe for a minute or so, and then back to action, I guess. So now what I wanted to say is last time I checked my recording, I also realized that with the last group we got, we also got a lot more engineers. So this would be a great idea to even improve our research a bit further. Also, when the number of sick people is going down, we also could reduce the number of active medical posts, also increasing our capacity for research again. So I think we do this. Just go through it. Right now I was thinking, is, yeah, both our iron mines are full with people, so I guess we will not run out of iron, or better, steel, is it called? Yeah, steel, not iron. So again, new sick people. Don't really like this. This is because they don't work quick enough on their housings. Don't really know why right now. So they seem to be busy with other things. Well, if they like to sleep in the snow, it's, well, it's their thing, not mine. So actually, how's the temperature right now? So, in this regard, everything looks fine. This is nice. I guess, again, it should be fine for now. Yeah, so I'm a bit of restless because, I'm actually not really sure why I'm so restless. But this time I just I'm just curious to see how this series is going and will go and how it will end or what will happen. And so now I'm quite interested to see what we will do in the next turn. So let me speed up a bit. Oh no, wait. Now Scott team is finished. And which one? This one, yeah. So last episode I sent this scout team to this node, to the Bridge of Winterhome, where we picked up the automaton, and I did this, so it's much much faster. So if you remember, or if you want to take a look back, when I sent it from here to here, it took around 16 hours, and when I sent this team from here to there, it took around 12 hours. So if the distance from node to the home or to the city really makes or is something you can use to think about how long it will take there, then I guess it's much much faster to send people from an already from the city to an already explored node than to send them from the city straight to an unexplored. So I guess this is probably better. So when we go near from here, it's only 11 hours. So and if you remember right, it was 1 day and 12 hours around from here to there. And this was 16. So 16 plus 12 plus 11 would be 27. So around 1 day, 3 hours. So I guess we saved 8 hours or so. So I think this is fine. This is nice. It's around a bit less than a working day. So I guess this is okay. Oh, what do we have here? Radical treatment, a note of thanks. A note was left for the doctor who performed the amputation on a frightened patient. It reads, "Thank you. I was in terrible pain and blinded by fear, and my choice would have doomed me. I may have been out the limb now, but I live." It was the right thing to do. Hope will rise slightly. Yes, of course it was the right thing to do. It's not like there was much choice. So, but I'm glad he's happy now. For now. we will see that he gets something shiny new. Later on. So he can work again. So now, housing area on you is also heated up. Great. I like this. It's good to have some heat. So, and only two people left who doesn't have any place to sleep. Is there really a problem with the food right now? Well, we do not have food, but we do have raw food, so it should be okay. I also never really bothered to take a look how much rations everyone actually needs. So is it one per people per day? I guess it should be around this ratio, but then I also signed that kids should get double. So does it mean that my kids eat more? So it would be 40 for the kids? Can't imagine that would be crazy amount. But yeah, let's see how this is going. So I also see a new loss. So last episode we finally finished our problem with the dead people by signing a law to just pull them all on the same hill, or just put them all on this pile. Yeah. And I did this because I wanted to sign organ transplantation, which to my wonder only increases the recovery rate of sick people but doesn't have any negative impacts. So like here you can see it would, when you sign this, hope will fall and discontent rises. You have this with every law you sign, but not with the organ transplants. This is weird, I guess. especially if I think about it, how many people talk about us in real life and are quite offended, or not only offended, but there's this huge gap of opinions how to go about this. But I'm not against this. I like it. It's okay. So, but right now we don't do this. We have sick people, but it's not like we are really running out of time right now. But what I want to do is to go this way, because I want to do something about our amputees. And the first step we have is to sign law to get a care house. So, and the care house is a place where we put all really gravely ill people. And yeah, the only drawback is that it is a new building, which makes room in the medical posts, and yeah, there's a lot of people you can put in there, but of course only separately. So let's sign this. Also, hope is rising a bit, which is great. And now we only have to do it, and there's the care house, which needs a warm place. So we have some spot here, and of course, nice. So this is one of the buildings I was thinking about that I could build here without leaving a gap, like when I wanted to think about to build a tent here. So this is nice. Nope, this is the wrong one. This was the cooking house. Oh no, it's the chaos. I read cooking house right now, so I'm a bit paranoid there. Great, flying hunter, nice. So then let's take a look at the next one, hunter tactics. So right now, the flying hunter should use. I can't check this right now, can I? No, I would have to build it first and then check how many people are in there. But let's just research it anyway. So we have people free. And yeah, then I guess the next thing we will do is to improve our steel production. I want to do this because the only way we have right, or the only way to get steel, is this two iron mines we have. Oh, let me start the research right now. Where is it? There. So let me start this. So the only place where we get iron is this two. Well, not iron, steel. Is this to steel rocks, and there is no other place we can get it except on the world map. And if we improve this place, then we have already our maximum increase of iron production for the most run of the, or for the most part of the game, and we will do this. So chaos promise fulfilled. Yeah, a chaos has been established in accordance with the new law. Hope rises. Yay. We already have some people in there. Oh, I see it's our kids. What? Can't change it right now. More survivors. Observatory. Something's amiss at the observatory. Snow covers the precious instruments and the dome is open, letting out a thin column of smoke. Someone's inside. Explore. The sun is dimming. Instead of astronomers, we are met by some of our lost people. They explained that they came here for help but found everybody dead. The astronomers continued their observation until they starved. What was so important for them? They wrote it up in the diaries. The loss of the sunlight can't be explained solely by the fooling of the atmosphere by the southern volcanoes. The sun is dimming. Ooh. Well, this is bad. I think so. Remember, kids, don't dim the sun. No, what, not everybody is happy. So again, we have the choice to bring people back to our city or leave them, and right now I don't see any mark that we get a new node to explore. So I guess we take our escort, or we escort them back, and let's see how long it takes. Around 6.5 hours. So if you think about it, the scout took 12 hours from here to there to explore first time. So I guess this is good improvement on the traveling time. So let's do this. And then, now that I think about it, there are again 34 more people. So we need more houses again. I also would like to have some more steel. I mean, the discontent isn't too high, so let's make this a 24-hour shift. Because I want to improve our food. And if you didn't already saw it, this flying hunter takes 40 steel per building, which is quite a lot. It's one of the most expensive buildings in the game. Isn't? No, that's. I think right now it's probably even the expensive one I can imagine right now. I'm not quite sure. Well, I guess the coal mine is a bit more expensive at the last level. But we'll see. So, food looks fine. I like this. This is good. So, let's keep going. So, also, I already mentioned it, now that we have our industry area down on the top here, we really are good with coal, and we are also quite happy with our wood supply, which is powered by our automaton. I guess we already can start building some houses for the people. Also, let me... Oh no, sorry. Yeah, I was thinking about speeding up a bit, but I already see that the next scout is up in a minute, in a second. So, this is bad. So I can't finish this building here. But I already mentioned that I want to try to pause buildings then rather than just getting rid of them. Oh, there are trees in the way. It's not nice. Oh, now that I think about it. Did it told me that when I build there, it will reduce shift? Can't use this to. Oh, this is right now a bit awkward. I want to get rid of this building. Oh no, not so fast. No. Yes, this one. So let me get rid of this big force. There are still trees, so now it doesn't tell me that if I build something here, it will get rid of the trees. But now that I think about it, of course later on, or what, maybe a bit later, I want to build some sawmills. So I guess we leave this open for now. And see to... Yeah, we leave it open for now. And try to build this one, and then we leave, and then we have some rooms later to place our sawmill. Well, it's not exactly as big as a house, I guess, so make it a bit more. And then of course keep going. We want to make something. We want to happen. Well, we want to. Oh, how do I explain it? I want things to happen. So, a woman in despair. A woman is sitting in a snow pit, holding her dead husband's hand, crying her heart out. Perhaps she should have agreed to give people proper burial after all. Make an exception and bury him. Discontent revives slightly. I did what I had to do. Well, I did what I had to do. Of course, I did what I had to do. Hunter's tactic is finished. Nice. So now this building only needs 10 workers and... compared to which, if you think about it, is now a huge improvement from the start. In the start, we had 15 people bringing 15 food, and now we have 10 people bringing 20 food. So from 1-to-1 ratio to a 1-to-2 ratio, which I think is a good thing. So I wanted to improve the steel, so let's do this. Also, the nice thing about the steelwork is this is one of the few good resource building. Well, it's also the only resource building to get steel, but it doesn't need any steel core. So the Waldron needs the steel core. The coal thumper, not, but the coal mine also needs a steel core, steam core. So I guess this is something to improve in. So let's do this. Nice. So, and also I wanted to check the scout. So now we are at the next point of our story. And let's see what's there. And also I see we get more steam cores, which is nice. Weather station. There's nobody in weather station, but everything still seems to be operational. We could try to find out what the scientists from the winter home were working on. So, let's see what they're doing. Weather station, grim forecast. We found scientists' notes. They predicted that the great cold is going to get much worse. That's more troubling is that the observation ended appropriately a month ago. There's also not a can of spam, not even a crumb of bread left in the pantry. It's obvious they were moved out for good. We can see the city of Winterholm from the roof of the weather station. So now we have new sites discovered. Which one is Winterholm, where we have to go for the story, and the other one is a coal mine. Which is also a great place, because I will go there first and only to throw something. It's not really needed right now, but I want to talk about this. And hope we have the time for this. Well, maybe next episode. No, no, it's not like we're ending right now, so I still have some time. The search for other cities. Abandoned station. The recent report from the weather station has got people talking. They are frightened that such an important facility was apparently abandoned. Some are starting to wonder whatever the evacuation from London was a good idea. A few are lamenting openly. I knew we shouldn't have come. At least London had real houses, not tents and wooden shacks. So it's only the problem about the houses. Hope falls slightly. We will have answers soon enough. Well, let's take a look at the coal mine first. Also still waiting for some steel, so I'll speed it up a bit. Also the next group is coming back, which is nice. More people. More people feeding to the machinery. Scout number one is not safely to the city. We can disband the scout for at the beacon or send them back into the Frostlands. Of course, we send them back into the Frostlands. It's not like they earned their share of rest. But on the other hand, now that I think about it, the question is where do we send them? So there's one cheesy thing we could do is we could first we could send them south and explore further. But we all have a scout team in the south, and the other thing we could do is to send them a bit further north already. Because when we finished our part of the story in the south, we will unlock more places in the north, and then they are already ready to go there. So let's do this. And of course, never forget to speed up the game. Speed, speed, speed. Let's keep going. Wait. So, 1 second slower. I wanted to improve the... No, first of all, I wanted to build new. Improve the flying hunter cell. So yeah, if you have a building that can be improved, I will show it with the steelwork again. Then you just can build the higher level on the already existing lower level, which is quite neat. I like this. And it also takes into account how much resources you already spend on the lower quality of the building. So in this case it should already counted as 20 wood paid, so this should only be 20 wood 40 steel. Yeah, so with this right now, well, right now it's a bit bad because this building here isn't fully built, and when the time is up for them to work, they have no time to work there. So actually, what is the problem right now? So 5 people are building right now, which, well, I guess you can let them do. Already, again, hungry people, but we still have food. So yeah, let's keep going, keep going, keep going. Already probably can guess how we call this episode. Now that I think about it. Let's build more of this. No, not this one. Just fill up this place. And then let's think about later how we eat this up. So, oh, I completely forgot that both of us got. So this guard was clear that it should be finished. So, and now we have the Gribliche coal mine. The coal mine is automated. The engine is pressurized, but the mining has stopped. The snow around it is untrodden, and an eerie silence hangs in the air. let us explore. We can get coal. So, more coal than we can use. This coal mine was operational until very recently. The machinery isn't running now, but there doesn't seem to be anything wrong with it. Perhaps the mine simply extracted its quota or filled the loading bay. We couldn't retrieve plenty of we could retrieve plenty of raw materials if we took the machinery apart. So, this is one of a few nodes where you have the choice to get a bit of material and leave the node as it is intact and give you the chance to create an outpost, or you could take everything apart and get some steam cores and of course a huge amount of resources, but you never will be able to create an outpost. So an outpost is the possibility to extract materials from the world map. This is one of the ways I always mentioned where you can get things. And there is one outpost for every resource, even for steam cores. So, and yeah, we could take it apart. I never run into problems with coal, but I also use this mine sometimes. So I'm not 100% sure right now, because last time I took it, well, last time I had no idea if you can take it apart later on. So, but I think if you want to go in a harder level, it probably is, it is in a, you could think about taking it apart, because there are a lot of resources here and the steam cores are limited in this game, so you could think about this. But right now we just leave it intact and take the coal with us and send our scout to the next so finally to Winterholm. Yeah, but another time. Another place. So, and I like to see how this is going. Also, are they on their way? Yes, they are also gathering food. So, right now, this is great. So, this building also only needs 10 people. So, because it's an improvement of the hunter's hunt, I guess it also gets improved by the reduction of the working force there, which is nice. So we will need this, of course. So, and also have 50% more food from the hunter's hut. So this is really awesome. And now we can set up more scientific research, which should speed up things a lot. So potentially we already doubled the potential research rate, which is great. I love this. But we also have a lot of sick people. I don't know why. Actually, yeah, why do we have sick people? So this could probably be because they are eating meals with sawdust. So, but normally when I have enough facilities for medical purpose, I never really cared about this, because it was going in, going out. So this is something you can let happen. So yeah. We survived another night. That has to count for something. At least we are alive. Not everyone is so lucky. Mm, won't know if you're so lucky. No. Of course you're lucky. I'm good with you. Of course, I take care of you all. I'm so good. So, also, I want to make sure that we don't run out of food. We already start building another another flying hunter. We really increase the number of people we have, so I guess this is not the bad idea. So now we improved our steelworks for this time. So there are a few things I could do right now. So one thing I could also do is to improve the housing, just to make sure the people have better places to stay in. It's not like I increase the amount of people that can live in one house, but what I do is I increase the heat or the insulation of the building. But for now it's not this code, so we don't need it. And another way would be to build a hot house, but we already have the flying hunter, which is okay. And yeah, our medical facilities are fine for now. So I guess what I want to do is going straight to this one. And maybe also think about increasing the heater a bit, But yeah, maybe even the efficiency, so we don't burn so much coal. I guess this is a good idea. So let's do this. So with this one, the generator doesn't use too much so much coal anymore. Well, only 10% less, but everything counts. The earlier you research this, the better. So we will do this, and then we go to probably maybe fourth level of technology, and then we go for the steelbox again. So right now I want to improve the steelbox. So now we have the steelbox and the steam steelbox, which is a bit better. If you can see, we have here 40 steel per standard day, and there we have 70, which is okay. I think it's not an awesome increase. It's not even double, but better than nothing. So also, this is nice how the flying hunters are really flying hunters. This is what I mean about this part of the steampunky theme I didn't expect to see. But I like it. It's cool. So anyway, this is also already another day gone. And I thank you really much that you were with me. And you will hear me next time. See you.